Yeah, that's my place. I mentioned going to pub crawl. I just came back from that. I think it's too, I don't know where I'm pointing this thing. It wasn't planned, at least not on my part, but I had a lot of fun. Oh, and I don't think I'm, or at least I think I mentioned in the video that never was, when it wasn't recording, but I tried haggis. A couple of us who arrived, like a couple of us from Arcadia, or the Arcadia program, who arrived at Hermitcroft together, we ended up just walking. They were really nice to help me with my suitcase, because I was the only one in this block, like literally the only one in the entire building. It was very, very quiet, very, very creepy. So creepy. I am weird on camera. Believe it or not, I've only had, what, 4 sips of some kind of dark beer, but I'm not drunk. You can choose to believe that or not. But, yeah, we just went and were wandering around looking for, like, what was in the area, and we just stopped in a pub, and it was a special for lunch, and it, like, why not? We'll try it. So I was sitting there while this guy, explained cricket and ate haggis, which I don't know what I was expecting from all the horror stories, but it was actually really good. I would eat that again. I mean, I know it, this, I don't know. I know I shouldn't have liked it, but it felt like a comfort food. It really did. And as someone pointed out on Facebook, you could eat the entire plate without needing teeth. But I don't know, we ended up getting into like a really interesting conversation about hot dogs. And how we couldn't eat those if we actually knew what was in them. And yeah, we met up with a really nice Canadian mother and daughter. The daughter was going to postgraduate studies at Edinburgh, and so we were talking to them for a while, and I'm rambling right now, but yeah, it's good. I was feeling kind of lonely before when I was the only one in the building, but people started coming in. Actually, at first it was creepy. I was in my bed, and I didn't get up until like 10. Because I was using my phone as an alarm clock, and I think I just, like, shut it off. And all of a sudden, I thought I heard voices across the hall. And it turned out it was one of the flatmates. Her name escapes me. I feel horrible. So I've just been kind of calling her San Francisco in my head, because she's from San Francisco. And she's studying here all 4 years. But another interesting note, I'm going to keep interrupting myself. The number of international students actually outnumbers the number of Scottish students in my flat. Because we have me, we have San Francisco, we have Tuscany, who's from Singapore. We started talking to one girl about San Francisco, and then we mentioned Tuscany, and she's like, oh, is she from Tuscany? Like, no, her name's Tuscany. But she's from Singapore. And then we have Jennifer, I think is from Glasgow. I think so. And then Emily is from like 3 hours away north somewhere. This is gonna be way too long to post. I'll still post it. And you might sit through it. But I don't even know where I was. But yeah, I heard voices at 10 o'clock, and then by the time I got dressed and went out there, no one was there. Dun dun dun. And so I was just sitting here like, people showing up, people are supposed to show up today. I don't have anyone's number. I can't call anybody. I can't remember what flat the other people were in for my program, because I'm a genius that way. And then Emily showed up, and we were talking for a while, and they were like, is anyone else showing up? And then finally, everyone started getting together. And then apparently there was a pub crawl. I didn't realize, because apparently the actual like Scottish students got all this paperwork about Freshers Week, and I think it's technically available for me, but I have to go find it at an office somewhere. So Emily was really nice, and she lent me her packet thing on Freshers Week, and it's no carrot, but there's a lot of random pictures of bulls in here. Not bulls, moose. Singular moose is moose, right? A moose? That's one of those words that you say, it doesn't sound like it should. But yeah, sorry. Moose. That's a Scottish moose. And they have all these other random, scarier looking moose pictures. But I'm going through that, trying to figure out what I want to do for Freshers Week. Because, you know, I'm not here to study. Who studies? And, although I do have a meeting, so don't worry, Mom, Dad. My academics is coming. Oh, and one more random tangent. I lent someone my Ethernet cord because the phone system, the like phone and internet system, comes with the Ethernet cords, and for some reason hers wasn't working. And I go like, oh, I have one, like I could, I don't know if it'll be long enough, but here. And her father was like, looks like someone knew what they were doing. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's my dad. Like, one of us has to. So props, Dad. You have the Scottish guy seal of approval. What does that mean? I don't. But yeah. Just gonna go to the end. Pub crawl. It was fun. We went to like 3 or 4 different places, kind of all in the area. So it was good to walk around. We had a huge group of people. I think some of the locals were getting annoyed, and half the time you couldn't get in the door of the pub because there were just too many of us. I didn't try anything until the very last place. I ended up kind of getting separated from my flatmates, and I talked to these two people, Nathan from California. I didn't even realize he was California. A lot of people were international students on this pub crawl. We had a guy from Norway I was talking to for a while, a bunch of people from America, a couple Canadians. But Nathan from California, who's studying computer science. And Katrina, with a C, who's from Glasgow, who I think is studying philosophy. Yes, she's studying philosophy. And we had a very nice conversation. A lot of people, I feel like, were talking with each other because they were drunk and it was like kind of a reduced atmosphere. No disrespect meant, but just, you know, alcohol loosens tongues. And we were talking from about 7:30 to 10:30. And before we started walking home, and even then, we walked home together and we were talking a bit. And they're both Whovians, which was awesome. That was like one of the first things we started talking about. But we started talking about random things. Like, we got on neuroscience for a while, and like aphasia, and Phineas Gage. I couldn't remember his name, and now I remembered his name, Phineas Gage. But like, him and internet memes. Nathan had he's watched some Vlogbrothers videos, but he's not a nerd fighter. But they're both Harry Potter fans. They were talking about Harry Potter musical and just random things, like mostly nerdy things, but then like family and how odd it is when like siblings and a family don't get along, and how we got along with our siblings, and what random things can we remember because we have very poor memories, and double rainbow. But it was really good, and I was proactive about it this time. I wrote down their flat numbers and such. 1111. So, okay. I think that is definitely a sign. That is a sign that I should stop talking to my camera and get ready. But yeah, one more thing. It was kind of funny because technically I could say a guy bought me a drink because Nathan got, like I said, some kind of dark beer just because he wanted to try it, and then he kind of like begged us to help him finish it because he didn't like it, because neither of us were really big drinkers. So yep. Am I really just gonna end it like that? I should have just cut the video back there. Just say, yep, and then just cut. Blackness. I will try to post stuff. I got a power converter The people were really nice. There's this huge bargain store with everything from like cards and duct tape to electronics and pots and pans and like towels and everything. And they were really nice and they helped me find out which one would suit my needs best. And right next to it was a fancy dress shop. So Halloween coming, might use that. But yeah, settled in. Looking forward to Freshers Week. It's International Day tomorrow. So they have a lot of the events for the international students. And I'm excited. I can't wait to get my schedule, start working on school, and start planning some non-school things. Hopefully with some new friends. So yeah, maybe someday I'll come back and I'll like condense all this. Like maybe the weekend I'll come and condense it, you know, like gather my thoughts and like record it for posterity. But for now, I hope you didn't watch all that. I can't give you that time back. I really can't. But yeah, I'm gonna go to bed. Good night. Although for you, sorry, one more thing. You, it's 6:13. Still, good night. Oh, one more thing. We were walking back and trying to talk about memory and everything, and Nathan also can recite the entire Jabberwocky. Ends the entirety of Monty Python's Holy Grail. I think I'm in love. I just pressed stop on that. Lana, if you watch this ever, you are gonna say something. And Bridget, you're gonna tease me, but it's not. So stop it. I mean it. Stop watching. You've been watching way too long. You need to stop watching. Go away. Now. Just down the computer. Just.